Okay, guys, we're back this week. Any questions about stuff that we've covered?
I have a couple questions.
All right.
So you talked about objections.
Yeah.
Why would the lawyers object in depositions?
In a deposition, you can only object to the form of the question, and you object to, I think it's the form of the question.
But it still has to be answered, right?
It still has to be answered.
It's
and then the judge will determine in court whether.
Okay.
Yeah, but they can object to the form of the question.
And that just for like that would just be for the jury, so the jury would review that.
Yeah.
And they still have to answer the question because there's no judge there to say that it's
sustained or
overruled.
So yeah. Okay, we're on chapter 13. Okay. Before we start, I'm going to tell you guys a couple of things.
How's that next week?
Still have 2 weeks. So next week will be a regular class, and then the following week is the week right before spring break. Okay? We're going to have guest speakers. We're going to have two guest speakers both nights, one on Monday and one on Wednesday. So one is going to be Whitney Alden. She's going to be speaking about CART, and then Sarah Murphy is supposed to come, I think, on that Wednesday. So, I pretty much have that set up. Sarah's pretty much set up for the Wednesday. I'm trying to nail Whitney down for the Monday. She said just any time after rodeo, and that gives her a week after, so it should be good. So what I'm trying to do is twofold. I'm trying to get them to come in here and speak to you about CART, which is pretty important, and to come talk about depositions, which is really important, and kind of give you a easier week right before we go on to spring break. So it's kind of good. Yeah, so it'll be good. Okay. Any questions? No? Okay. Chapter 13, how to mark exhibits. Okay, the objectives is discuss what constitutes an exhibit as it relates to the legal proceedings. Explain what marking an exhibit for identification means, and how an exhibit is received into evidence, how and where to mark exhibits either for identification or as received into evidence, various procedures for marking different kinds of objects as exhibits, various parentheticals that relate to the marking of exhibits, and discuss what happens to exhibits once they have been marked and received into evidence. Okay? The marking of exhibits is an art and skill in and of itself that requires common sense and practice. Exhibits are material items of physical evidence introduced by attorneys to corroborate and confirm oral testimony or to introduce new evidence based on an exhibit, all for the purpose of helping the presenting side to prove their cause. Exhibits are usually marked for identification so that they can be discussed. Okay? And I brought some examples here. Okay, respondents exhibits, and then just the exhibits. I had run out of some of the other ones or whatever, so I'm going to kind of pass them around, and you're going to take one, get a sheet of paper or something that you have, and I'm going to have you mark it as an exhibit, and I'm going to show you how to mark it, and you're going to do it. To me, like, I learn better by doing something or somebody showing me one time, and then I don't forget as easily. But if you see somebody do it, it's like, yeah, And then you go to take that first deposition, it's like, what? Mark an exhibit, what? Yeah, so we're going to do it. And as simple as it may seem, hopefully you won't forget when you go take your first exhibit, I mean your first deposition. Okay? So, let me kind of draw it here. And then I'm going to kind of pass them around. So it usually has like, so this is kind of what it looks like, okay? So I think I've kind of shown you guys, it just kind of looks like that. Exhibit, respondents exhibit, then I just have another white exhibit. You have state's exhibits, plaintiff's exhibits, movement's exhibits, respondent, defendant, intervener. So there's a lot of different people, so you have to be careful with the way that you mark exhibits, okay? I'm going to pass these around so you can look at them. Take one, I don't care really which one, but kind of look at all of them, take one, and then mark your piece of paper or whatever at the bottom. Right-hand corner should be where your exhibit goes, okay?
Bottom
right-hand corner. So the exhibit sticker, this is the sticker itself, but if this was the exhibit, then you want it right here, in this area, right in here, okay? But this is the exhibit sticker, so.
And where do we get the stickers from? We have, like, special court orders, do we order them online?
If you work for the court, they usually have them,
okay.
So you'll usually get them from the district court's administrator, mm-hmm. And they have all of them.
Okay.
I mean, whatever you can think of, they have. Okay.
And they give them to me, or to them, they're there for purchase.
No, they give them to you.
Okay.
Yeah. So you just have to go check them out. Okay. So you just tell them, hey, I need some state's exhibits. So, like, down with the county, like with us, I mean, they have, like, a big old storeroom or whatever. So when we need stuff, we just kind of go in there and say, hey, I need some Post-its, blah, blah, blah. So you have to put on their Post-its, one pack, state's exhibit, one pack, blah, and then sign off on it so that they keep track of all this stuff, okay? But if you go work for a firm, then you'll get them from there also. You'll get them from them, okay? And usually it's plaintiffs and defendants. On depositions, they might have some other stuff or whatever. So, okay. So, when someone asks you to mark an exhibit and they bring it up and it's this, you know, piece of paper, and they say, you know what, Judge, I want to have this marked for identification as state's exhibit number one. Okay, so they hand it to you. That's what you do. You take your state's exhibit, which is red. I didn't have one, but whatever. But take your state's exhibit, put it right down here in the corner, and if there's stuff on there, be careful, okay? Be sure to ask the attorney, is it okay to mark it here? Because you don't want to put the sticker on top of something that they're going to be asking that witness about, okay? And like on pictures and stuff, they usually want it on the back side, okay? Because they don't want it on the front side of the picture because they want to be able to see the whole picture. Does that make sense to you guys? Okay. So what I do is I put the exhibit sticker, bottom right-hand corner, looking. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I'm going to put number one. All right. Then I put my initials. And then I put the date. So it's
22.
So that's the way that it should look. I want you to mark your exhibit right now. So I've just asked the judge, I want this marked for identification, and I've just brought it to you. You put the sticker on there, that's the way you mark it. 1-EZ-222-17, or whatever your initials are. And then on your piece of paper, remember that little worksheet that you have where you put, you know, states, defendant, respondent, whatever, I put one, and then...
Picture.
Mark, then out here, picture, or order. Okay?
So it's marked yet, but it's not yet received.
It's not yet received.
Okay.
Okay? You remember how we do that?
Mm-hmm.
How?
It's marked.
What about when they offer it?
Offer, which is a circle around the M.
Circle
and
around
then
the M.
It's a check
Holy
mark.
Crap, somebody was paying attention. Weird. Offered is around the M.
And then it's a check mark.
And then a check mark when it's admitted. Okay? Now, guys, when you go work for somebody, whether, usually the judge isn't going to tell you how to do your stuff, but when you go work for a firm, they might tell you, this is the way we do it. So you may want to do it that way. Okay? You don't have to. Whatever helps you keep track of it is what they're more worried about, I think. Okay? All right? That's how you mark an exhibit. Very important. Very important, guys. It seems really simple, but very important. Initials, date. Because if you forget one of these things, well, it was a murder trial that we did that lasted a month, and we had four different reporters come in. And we had exhibit number one marked, I don't know by who. I don't even know on what date. I guess it's going to be in the transcript, hopefully, if that person's still alive. But, you know, hopefully, you know, so it's real important to keep track of these things because of that, okay? And exhibits are really important. All right? Got it? All right. So after testimony is elicited to bring out the validity of an exhibit, it may be received into evidence. That's what we just talked about. At depositions, exhibits are marked for identification only. They may or may not be introduced during the trial of a case. So if they mark something, that's all they're going to do. So in a deposition, you don't really have to worry about having it offered and admitted, because they're just going to mark it then. Okay? So it's going to be deposition. Deposition exhibit number one, or deposition exhibit number two, or whatever, okay? Which would be a good question.
Deposition, or is it plaintiff?
Sometimes they're deposition exhibits.
Okay.
So that's a good question to ask Sarah when she comes. And I'm going to try to remember to tell her to bring some exhibit stickers that she uses and stuff and how she does it. It should be the same, but anyway.
Have you ever lost track of an exhibit? Had problems with exhibits?
I haven't. You know, but we're a little bit luckier in court, only because the clerk keeps track of them.
And like, that's what Kristen was saying. Like, she doesn't have to worry about exhibits.
And like, our little clerk is a VA. She takes her job serious. So she knows where everything is at all times, whenever. And I'm telling you, she's about this tall, and she doesn't forget anything, ever. Good, bad, whatever, but she doesn't. And I'll tell her, hey, I need those exhibits on the Herrera case. Okay. We may have had 9 different Herrera cases. She knows exactly which one I'm talking about. I mean, you know, so that some of them are good. Some of them are really good. You know, and hopefully, you know, if you get into court, you get one of those. You know, but they keep track of the exhibits. So what they do is they'll introduce them. You're pretty much responsible for them until you get them to her or him. And then you give them to them, and then they fill out this sheet that has the style of the case and everything on it. Remember, you know, like the front style page or whatever? They put that on the front of one of those manila folders or whatever. and then they put on their state's exhibits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, respondents' exhibits 1, 2, and 3, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so you know exactly what's in there. Okay? And it's important because, like, if they say, you know what, we're going to appeal that case on Herrera. So we're going to need you to type it up. It's 4 days, termination, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Well, they read from some documents, and you have to, and it's like, I wrote what I heard. I mean, I don't know. It said Xanax. Z-A, I don't know. They were reading from the doc, and you just go into that document, and it has all that information there. Okay? Especially like when you go into like a deposition that, you know, somebody will bring a CV. Really important. Y'all know what that is? Curriculum vitae? It's almost like a resume. It's a, you know, fancy term for a resume. So these guys will bring a curriculum vitae in, you know, whatever, and it has all their stuff, you know, from the time that they were born to the day that they're taking that depo almost and what they've done. You know, so, and I took a guy that, he was a personal pilot, but he had done all this stuff. I mean, tours and, I don't think it was Vietnam because he wasn't that old. You know, and it may have been, you know, one of the other ones, the Saudi war or whatever. But I mean, he flew planes there, bombing stuff and whatever. Then he comes back and works for a commercial airline, and then he worked for some personal people, you know. So he brought his whole CV, and it's usually supposed to be one page, and his was like three, loaded, you know, with just stuff. So it's pretty important. I mean, this guy had done all these things, you know, of schools that he had gone to, places he had been, and blah, blah, blah. So it had all of that stuff on there. So, I mean, you know, it's good when you go back and do that transcript to have that information, okay? Okay, generally most exhibits in a case are identified and received into evidence in court by the party bringing the suit. The exhibits are offered in court first for identification and then are shown to opposing counsel and the court. Objections and rulings may be made, after which questioning proceeds regarding an exhibit. So I don't want to get into a law school review, but this is kind of the way it goes. They can't offer an exhibit without proving it up. Okay? So what they do is they'll say, Judge, I want to approach and have this exhibit marked. Okay, so they have the exhibit marked, and they can't go, I want this admitted into evidence. But what is it? You haven't even said what it is. We have no idea what it is. You have to prove it up. Okay. So then they start asking the witness, okay, look at the photos. Look at the series of photos that I gave you, and do you recognize them? Yes. Did you take those photos? Yes, I did. Okay. Well, they just proved it up. That's all they have to prove, is that this person was the one who's going to know what that exhibit is about. They just have to show minimum stuff, but they have to show that this person is going to know what they're talking about on this exhibit. If it's like, have you ever seen these photos before? Nope. Didn't you take them? Mm-mm. Okay. We want those admitted into evidence. Not going to happen. Not going to happen. Unless you have a very lazy attorney on the other side that doesn't object and they just come in. But any half-decent attorney is going to say, Judge, we object. They have not proven these up. They're not, we don't want them admitted. We object to them being admitted. Okay? Well, then you bring in another witness and prove them up. Okay. What constitutes an exhibit? Physical evidence may include guns, bullets, medical records, marriage certificates, soil and quicksand samples, really, tapes and slides, videotapes, stamps, charred quicksand. Rugs, anything. I mean, I took an exhibit once where, I mean, there was a maintainer. I think I told you guys about that, right? The maintainer? Yeah. Was an exhibit. Really? I put in that little sticker on this thing that, I mean, is probably 3 times the size of this room. looks a little funny when we're going to mark it where everyone's going to be able to see it, so.
Did you really put a sticker on it?
No, they were more talking about, it. It's like, you know, this is, you know, exhibit number 4, and this is the maintainer. And it, I think I told you I killed somebody, I backed up on somebody and killed somebody or whatever, so. It was a little horrific, so. But, anyway. Some exhibits are large, some are small. We're bringing a large exhibit into the courtroom is physically impossible. Photographs may be submitted. Complete files containing hundreds of pages or textual material may be admitted as well. In short, almost anything imaginable can be marked. So anything can be an exhibit, anything. You know, she filed the end of a toothbrush and killed the guy. So now the toothbrush is an exhibit. I mean, and you see all these things. I mean, you know, especially like in court, you're going to see all kinds of stuff. You know, because those guys will make a shank out of anything. You know, so if they come back and they get tried for that thing, and it's like, well, we need this this shank marked as an exhibit. Well, it's a ballpoint pen that was just sharpened down, you know, with some tape around it. Doesn't matter. That's what he killed the guy with, you know. It doesn't matter. So anything can be used as an exhibit. Anything can be an exhibit. Okay, marking exhibits. To mark exhibits properly, a reporter should have a variety of supplies on hand. These supplies may include an exhibit stamp, a stamp pad, or other marking materials. I don't know. An exhibit stamp is probably one of the most useful or universal methods of marking exhibits. I disagree. It's a stickers. Okay? I've never seen a stamp in my life. Okay? So I have no idea what they're talking about, but whatever. The exhibit stamp should have a blank line for the party presenting the exhibit, a blank line following by the initials ID or EBD that can be filled in with a number or letter, and a blank line for indicating whether the exhibit is marked for identification or received into evidence. The next line should contain a place to insert the date, and the last line should contain the name and title of the court reporter. And that's kind of what we have here, okay? Number, initials, date. I mean, I guess you'll carry these things anyway, but you know, sometimes the attorneys will say, you know, I have a series of papers and I need them stapled or whatever. I don't bring a stapler. It's not really your job to do it for them, you know, but if you have it, you know, hey, do you have a paper clip? Yeah, and you just happen to have it or whatever. So I think that's what they're talking about here, marking materials or whatever. So you just want to keep them together, whatever. That it's more their responsibility to keep their stuff together. So, but I mean, if you have stuff, great. Where to mark exhibits? Physically marking exhibits requires placing identifying information somewhere on the exhibit. If it is large, cumbersome exhibit, the exhibit information should be placed on a tag and then tied to the exhibit. If it is a document or a photograph, markings can be placed in the upper right corner. I don't know. I was always taught it was the lower right corner. Lower right corner. Okay? But, I mean, whoever you go to work for may tell you, look, this is the way that we mark them. Upper right corner. I don't think it's really going to hurt anything. The only thing that's going to hurt is if you put that sticker over something. You know, you don't want to put that sticker right here in the middle of that thing. Okay? Well, it just covered up the gun, a picture of the gun that killed the guy. Oh, that was Exhibit 1. You think so? Yeah, you just covered it up, but whatever. So no, it doesn't go in the middle. It's going to go on one of the sides. Try to keep it to the side. Or on the back, okay? Avoid marking exhibits in places that would cover any writing or material that's part of the exhibit. Just talked about that. Check carefully as to any attorney's preference when marking exhibits consisting of more than one page or more than one unit. So like in my court, and you'll kind of know because you'll get to know the people that you do depositions with, either sit in your court, the DAs, attorneys, whatever. So like they'll say, Dave, I need these photos marked. How do you want them marked? Do you want them marked as one or do you want them marked individually? Well, I'm going to show them all and there's like 40-something pictures. You know what? Just mark it as one exhibit. Okay. But they may say, you know what? I want them marked individually because I want to be able to say on this exhibit, I want you to go on exhibit 4 or exhibit 1F and tell me what that depicts. Well, there's trash strewn all over the place and there's blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. Oh, okay. Whereas you're going to go, well, in this picture, you know, what does this depict? Well, it shows the bedroom and it's strewn all over and there's blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. Well, when it goes up on appeal, it's easier for them to go through and say there's 1F. Oh, there's 1F. Okay. They're not there. You're the eyes and ears for them. So your transcript is the eyes and ears for them. Okay? So what you put in there is what they see and hear. You know, and they don't have like inflections, you know, of laughter and screaming and sarcasm.
So you might put like a parenthetical if they didn't specify, if the lawyers didn't specify exactly which exhibit they were pointing to.
I usually wouldn't. I mean, if they say, you know what, it's right here. It's right here in this picture. Then I would put indicating. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't put pointing at the bike, the spokes on the bike. Too much info, because you have no idea what they're actually trying to do, and you're not getting in the mind of that witness. All you're doing is just indicating. Well, they're pointing at something, so it's the attorney's job to bring that out. What to mark on an exhibit. At the very least, the marking of an exhibit should contain the party who is introducing the evidence, the exhibit number, the date, and the reporter's name or initials. Usually all plaintiff's exhibits are marked with a number, and all defendants are marked with a letter. Not true. That's why you have the different stickers. Okay? Respondent, intervener, states. So it doesn't matter. I always mark it with the number unless they ask me to do it differently. So the way that they do it, you know, and they may do it before. And some of the attorneys will do it before. So I say, Judge, well, they'll come up before a hearing and say, Dave, I need some stickers, some exhibit stickers. Okay. Well, I know that she's a respondent, you know, because she represents mom or whatever, so I give her some respondent's exhibits. Well, she's already done it. Judge, I want to hand the witness what I've marked as respondent's exhibit A. That's not the way that I do it. I didn't mark the exhibit, so I don't put that I marked the exhibit either. Okay? That shows that the attorney marked it. Okay? And, you know, we want to offer it or whatever. You know, and sometimes I'll ask the judge, do you want me to mark that exhibit or whatever? And I know that she kind of marked it, but yeah, you know what, we need to do it the right way. So a lot of times, the attorneys won't follow protocol, okay? So you kind of have to be a little careful about that, okay? Be a little aware. It's not that big of a deal. It's more their job to make sure that they do it the right way. But if they're just in that big of a hurry, but I mean, and then you have attorneys that, I mean, and I love her to death, the old DA that we used to have, she would always come to me before, hey Dave, I have 6 exhibits I need marked. We haven't even started the hearing. Okay. Mark them all down, put my initials on them, number, everything, ready to go. Judge, I'm gonna put, I want to approach the witness, okay? And I'm gonna show the witness what has previously been marked as state's exhibit number 1 and show that to the witness. Okay? Well, I already marked them. So all I have to do is put mark at the beginning of the before we even start the hearing.
Right.
You know, mark the exhibits.
So that comes up in the transcript before everything's happened, because that's exactly when it happened.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I marked it before.
Okay.